My name is Dr. N. Baladastagiri. So today I would like to present a small topic on how to write a research paper. The total presentation is based on my perception. So coming to the topic of presentation, so whether you are pursuing your research in the field of science or arts or literature or engineering, you will probably have to write a research paper. So writing research paper is very complex and time-consuming process. And what really important is that, so this research paper makes students in getting their PhD. So it is also an open secret that academic writing is hard, but writing skills are very important for your success in pursuing your research careers. That's why you should work hard to master the art of paper writing. But it looks like a daunting task when you are just starting out the process of writing a paper. But staying very organized and calm and planning your time can make the process very easy. So as per my point of view, there are three stages in writing a research paper. So if you follow these three stages, you can bring out the best paper. The first stage is research your topic. The second stage is drafting your paper. The third stage is revising your paper. Again, in each stage, there are different steps. So now let us look into the each stage in detail. Stage one is research your topic. So in this stage, there are a few steps to be followed. So among them, the first one is focus your research on a narrow topic. So when you start to conduct your research, try to make your research area very narrow. Why? Because if the research area is broad, you cannot defend your argument or you cannot defend your research problem. So if your research problem is more refined, means then you can easily pass the argument and you can defend the research problem with clear research results or evidences. Even if you feel that if you are getting off the topic, then you can reread the topic in order to make yourself engaged with the research work. And you can get back onto the track. For example, you might start with a general subject like implementing biomedical integrated circuits. So later on, you can focus on various applications of biomedical ICs like ECG, EEG, etc. So finally, you can select any one of the applications and you can start working on it. The second step in the stage one is search for credible sources. So if you are writing your research paper for your PhD or for your postdoctoral fellowship, start by checking your research area and various textbook references in that research area. Look for books, articles, and various scholarly work related to your topic of research. Then check the references of those works for additional information. The most useful and credible sources include the scholarly articles published by the other scholars who have already engaged in the field of your research area. Also, you can go for the databases like Scopus, Web of Science, IEEE, and scientific studies of various industries. Moreover, check your source dates and make sure that the papers what you have collected are up to date. Next thing is that you can evaluate how the other scholars have approached your topic. Identify the authoritative works that are accepted in the high quality journals. Additionally, look for the methods and the techniques used by the scholars and decide yourself with the help of your supervisor which method or technique is having the strongest evidence for the research problem. Based on this method, so you can go for the development of new method or new technique. The next one is very important thing is you must include a bibliography or you should cite the works what you have used. So keep your papers organized, list the papers and format them as per the assigned style. The last and final step in the stage one is preparing a working thesis. When you develop a working thesis, you learn more about your topic. Thesis is not only just a fact or opinion, but it is a specific debatable claim of your research. Your working thesis is the foundation for your entire paper structure, and it uses an idea of whether your paper will be an argumentative paper or an analytical paper. The stage two in writing the academic paper is drafting your paper. The steps involved in this stage two are: the first one is create an outline to map out your paper structure. So you can use Roman numbers, or you can use letters, or you can use bullet points in order to organize your paper outline. Then start with the introduction, write your total working thesis, and jot down your key features of results that you use to define your argument or research problem. So later on, sketch the body, paragraphs, and conclusion. So next, the second step in the stage two is present your thesis and argument in the introduction. Start with an attention grabbing sentence. So in order to draw the attention of your audience, the starting line of your paper should be a attention grabbing one, and then introduce the topic, then present your working thesis to let the audience or readers know what you are arguing. For the remainder of the introduction, map the evidences. Next one is step three, so which is build up your argument in the body paragraphs. First, see the context of your readers, then focus on a specific element or the result that supports your work or research. So each idea should flow to the next, so that the reader can understand easily the connection between the two different paragraphs, or connection between the two different lines, and he can understand the logic behind the data what you have written. And the next one is address a counter argument to strengthen your work. It's not always necessary to address a counterpart or counter argument that can help to make your argument more convincing. So after specifying your evidence or results, so mention a contrasting view of the topic. So then explain why this counterpart or contrasting view is incorrect, and then explain why your claim has more advantages when compared with the existing solutions. Note that whatever the counterparts you are bringing, make sure that they are strong claims and they are from the highly referred journals, so that they are good for comparison. So don't bring the papers or the results from the weak and easily diminishable journals. So the next step is summarize your argument in the conclusion. First, tell the audience or readers what you want to tell them. So after the paper's body, remind the steps you have taken to defend your problem. Sum up your argument or problem, but don't simply rewrite your introduction. So to make conclusion more interesting, you should connect your work to a broader topic or theme, so that it can reach the broader section of audience, or it can reach the more number of audience. The next one is stage three, so which is nothing but revising your paper. So these are the following steps that are involved in the stage three. The first one is ensure your paper is well organized. So after finishing your first draft, give it a read and look for any organizational issues. Make sure that each sentence and paragraph is well connected with the next one. So at this time, you may have to rewrite a paragraph, or we have to swap the different sections or different lines in the paragraph in order to get the link between the two lines or two paragraphs. But giving a time for the revision is very, very important in order to get the best work. So this is also a great opportunity for us to make sure your paper fulfills the parameters of the research problem and the results what you have prompted. And the next step is cut out unnecessary words.
In addition to your paper's organization, so look out for specific words that make your language commendable. So double check that you have used the active voice instead of using the passive voice, and also make sure that you have used the clear words. So try to avoid the extra words or extra paragraphs, so just to fill up the pages. And the step 3 is proofread for spelling and grammatical and formatting errors. So after you have revised your paper's outline, organization and the context, then fix the typos and the grammatical errors if present. Read your paper loudly to ensure that you can catch each and every error. So as you read, check for the flow, and if there are any unnecessary lines, means you can remove them. So the next step is ask a co-scholar or supervisor to read your work before you submit it. Have at least one or two people assess your paper organization, spelling and grammar, so before you can submit it for the general. So new readers can help you in finding any mistakes and any unnecessary sentences. Moreover, it is very good to get feedback from one person who is familiar with your work and the other person who is not familiar with your topic. The person who knows your topic can ensure your results are good, the results are good or not, and they are meeting the specific problem or not. So a person who is unfamiliar with your research area can help you to make your paper is clear and easily understandable. So these are the various stages and the steps involved in each stage in order to write a paper. Hope this lecture will make you to write the best paper. So all the best. Thank you.